Hey Rahul, so welcome. Thanks so much for taking out the time. Let's say we look at other companies who are probably not as large as you, and you know, maybe not as well funded, but operating in a slightly similar. And I'm talking more about technology internet businesses. Now, for the next 6 months to 12 months, what should their strategy be? Like, how should they plan to re-accelerate? How should they look at capital expenditures around operational expenses, around growth, around people, customers? Like, how should they sort of, you know, look forward for the next 6 months?
One thing remains true for everyone is conserving cash, because nobody can predict how the impact of COVID would be, right? Specifically in the B2C space, where you have to see a change of behavior. So streamlining operations and reducing costs is the new normal. Work from home has become another normal. So the immediate impact could be, how can you reduce the fixed expenses because of people that are already there because of work from home becoming no normal, and people being as efficient as they would be while they're at work in office. Another aspect would be engaging on all sides of your supply chain, touching all nodes of your ecosystem. So if you have three nodes of ecosystem, touching and understanding how they are behaving with the impact of COVID. Are they reducing their inventory? Is the customer reducing his spend, or probably customer is becoming more bullish on marketing? So engaging more would become the new normal, because you cannot assume anything anymore. You have to be on the same page with all nodes of your ecosystem, and then only you can plan anything around it. And of course, planning would be more around ensuring that how can you deliver more, and also using an existing operational strength to diversify if possible. I think these are a few aspects that will go a long way in ensuring that you are ready for re-acceleration whenever the operations restart.
You know, I think in the last 40-45 days, obviously there's been a lot of ups and downs, and also a lot of back and forths on what's allowed, what's not allowed, green, red, yellow, orange zones, and essential versus semi-essential, urban, rural. So there have been so many dimensions of regulations. Right. What's your view, and you know, what did the government do well, you know, for these last 30-40, and you know, what sort of impacts you? What could have done better in these last days? But more than that, I think looking ahead, for the next 6 to 12 months, which are very important because a lot of disruption has been created in the economy, what are the important regulatory interventions you feel the government should bring into place, right, so that the sector can get back to the pre-COVID levels comfortably and at the right profitability?
Over the past 1.5 months, of course, government did a great job by ensuring that we are not impacted as badly as we would have if we were not under lockdown. And even the places are opening up locally. So if you look at it, few of our manufacturing hubs, they have opened up, and government has defined few SOPs which you have to follow. So of course, you're following that. That has been the help that it got from the government in terms of ensuring that even manufacturing sector can come back to operations at least. On the regulatory side, a lot more spend on the manufacturing side, because that is one way of providing the stimulus to the whole economy. So ensuring that the past projects which were not seeing the light of the day would be started now, right? And a lot more newer spend would happen. That is one part that we're hoping that the government would continue with. Another aspect is ensuring that financial stimulus, that the money is available to the SMEs at a lower interest rate and at a larger leverage. For if earlier the leverage was 2 crores, probably over a land of 1 crore, probably that could probably increase to 3 crores, so that they can streamline their operations more and do more, because capital remains one of the hindrance for a lot of suppliers to scale. So these two aspects, where increasing spend on the manufacturing side, another is providing the financial stimulus to the whole industry in terms of leveraging more from the capital. And third would be providing ways to do all of it, but at the same time being safe. You know, so if transportation is one way that laborers were moving, how can you, you know, ensure that they could move at the same pace that they were moving before, but not being unsafe? So these three aspects probably is something which the government, of course, is working on. We would see probably in some time some policy measures from their side.
Where are you on this whole debate between lives and livelihoods, right? I mean, we've been following a extreme lives approach. Now we're moving slightly towards hybrid. I don't know which direction we'll sort of move back. Now, what's your view on this?
Still be in the hybrid way. You can't compromise lives for livelihood. Of course, both have to go hand in hand.
Or vice versa, basically.
Exactly, right? So you can't let go of livelihood at the same time say we'll preserve lives, because it won't happen. So you have to have a balanced approach. We have to accept it as a new normal probably, and develop strategies around making it a new normal. which in turn will give ideas to people, you know, new startup would come up, new companies would come up who would provide, solutions to make this new normal work. That's another business opportunity for probably a few new entrepreneurs to make the new normal work. So we as a race have been able to, you know, move ahead in time by innovating, and this will be another innovation which will be there. You should probably move to a balanced approach.
The more we speak to people, you know, we are realizing that now the opinion and the viewpoint of people is changing towards, hey, you know, no point overreacting. You know, this is a crisis. You know, we know this is a tough situation that the world is dealing with. Bring in the necessary reforms and guidelines and precautionary measures, you know, that everyone needs to take. But you cannot bring life and sort of economy to a standstill. So we must continue to move on, but with the necessary guidelines and the precautions, so that, you know, we minimize any impact to lives and sort of get back to normal faster. I think, you know, we've seen that's what different people are now coming to realize, that hey, the lockdown is not going to completely eliminate. This thing is bound to remain, you know, for a longer time till it's completely eliminated. So you need to sort of live life, you know, do you think that's the right approach, or
you have to accept as a new normal and come back to operations? Both for economy, it's good. For people, it's good, because even staying back is not clearing out COVID. The cases are increasing with time, and it's going to be the new normal. So you have to accept it and prepare for it, right? Sitting down at home is not going to help you prepare for it.
Do you think this is going to sort of drive a lot of inflation in your sector? Now, I mean, you guys are sort of less consumer focused, so, you know, sort of more protected from inflation. But at least from the point of labor supply, raw material supply, you know, and the demand being there, you know, what's the sort of impact going to be on prices?
Prices probably would remain the same or might increase a little bit, which will help the supply, because the market might be supply constrained for the coming time, the immediate future of quarter one or quarter two, where labors have gone back and then you need to bring them back. If you have to bring them back, you have to incentivize them with probably better payment. That might happen. Of course, we haven't seen it happening at the moment, but that's of course a personal opinion, where the prices might increase a little bit on the supply side, so that you can make sure that more supply is inclined towards working with you. And if someone has stopped operation, how do you bring them to operation? Is by giving them a better payment or better incentive.
Anything else you want to share?
Nothing much from my side. It's always a pleasure talking to you.
Thank you so much for taking out the time. You know, wish you all the best and the health to you, your family, friends, colleagues, and you know, hopefully you guys get back to the growth sort of you were on, you know, and get back to sort of normal to pre-COVID levels. You know, wish you all the best.